Okay. Spoilers!
Berserker Unleash. Ryan, you're here.
Can't believe I cried in this movie.
Why did you cry?
Spoilers. As
we're
we said,
in spoilers.
We're in spoilers.
I'll put something on the screen.
At the end. Yeah. Like, there were two moments where I, like, when Charles died in the middle.
No!
We're in spoilers, it's fine.
Okay.
It was, like, that hit me, and I was like, oh, man. And, like, I was almost there, almost there. And then, which you missed because you went and took a piss.
Yeah.
so, it had Logan standing there at the grave. He's just buried, you know, he's just buried Charles, and you can see he's feeling with this emotion, and he wants to say these certain things, but he can't find the words. And then he just gets, I'm like, you know, he has a lovely moment with Laura, and then he can't get the words, and he fucking explodes. And then he walks away and starts beating the shit out of a car.
With a shovel.
With a shovel. Like, you know what I mean? So, like, that was such a pivotal and powerful moment.
Because he was kind of saying, shove it, but it was a metaphor. He couldn't say shove it, so he...
Because he kept repeating a line, it's like, hey, it's near the water, and he was trying to sort of say, this is probably the best place that he could be buried. He was trying to have that emotional moment. He could just tell, it was a fucking frustrated man, just wanted to get it out, and he couldn't. And at the end, when, as I said, he gets the shit kicked out of him for the last time, and it all sort of goes quiet, and... moment.
We should say spoiler story, is that Laura is his daughter from his genetics.
So she's X-23.
Logan didn't bang someone and have a mutant baby.
he had a surrogate Mexican girlfriend.
Yeah, Laura was a part of a generation of kids that were born in a lab with mutant genes because these scientists were trying to weaponize them.
After mutants have been eliminated,
this is in 2029, so mutants are pretty much gone. So this girl smuggles Laura out, gets her to Logan, and she's like, get her to North Dakota.
The safe haven. It's
Eden.
Eden, which is a comic thing, because the comic book was in the film saying Eden. So that's the whole quest. He's trying to get her to North Dakota. Where she finds her other mutant friends on the way there, and that's when the big climatic battle happens because the government finally gets in. But the biggest gripe I had with it was the antagonist. The main antagonist who didn't say anything, but it was Wolverine.
They cloned Wolverine.
They made a fresh Wolverine, what he was back in the day.
A perfectly manufactured, built nothing on rage.
No emotion, no conscience, no morals. Just do as you're
pissed
told.
Off.
Yeah.
Which essentially was Wolverine with a shaved head.
Yeah. And it was that Wolverine that killed Xavier.
Yeah.
Xavier had this really nice monologue in bed, because Xavier's really sick. He's old.
He's got a degenerative brain disease.
The whole
they said.
Kidnapping him thing you were saying before. He's the strongest mutant there is, and probably ever has been and ever will be, which is all in his mind. He's got like super mind powers, and he's got a degenerative brain disease, so he has seizures, and when he does, just everything within miles gets fucked up. And there's like everyone freezes, and they're like bleeding, and they can't move, but they're still conscious because they're looking around. Really, really bad for him to have a seizure. So that was, at the start of the movie, the whole thing was Logan keeping him sedated so he didn't have any seizures, trying to raise enough
to
money.
To sort of allow him to die in somewhat peace.
Yeah, no. Well, he was trying to raise enough, get enough money to buy a boat and then just live out their days out in the sea, where Charles couldn't hurt anyone if he went mental and you know, his mind melted everybody. Which, of course, doesn't happen because Laura dumped on his doorstep and he has to do all that.
God damn it. I'm so glad I'm going to the doctor.
Looked at me. But yeah, that's the plot.
Okay, now we can get to jump into spoilers.
We're already in spoilers.
Spoilers. Well, my spoilers. okay, so essentially there's things that are alluded to throughout the movie.
Yeah.
And essentially it implies that, exactly, that he was keeping Xavier there. He couldn't kill him because he was his friend.
Yeah.
But he kept him sedated enough so that these mind powers didn't cause chaos and kill everybody. Now, in regards to that, when they were at the Vegas hotel, like, it was affecting, like, the bad guy, cyborg dude, and it was affecting Stephen Merchant's Caliban character, and Hugh Jackman, and some of the soldiers were just frozen, so I don't know whether it affects people, just mutants.
I think it just messes everyone, because there were people, like, when he was walking through the casino, the woman, like, there was a woman who was just a bartender, just stopped,
But they were frozen. They weren't like bleeding and dying. Like they weren't.
But you can see her sort of like she's like.
They can't breathe.
Like it just stopped.
Maybe.
Because and then at the end they announced that 400 people were exposed to temporary paralysis, and I was like, okay,
did they?
Yeah. There's a little bit of news cut. I giggled because I'm like, that's not a small event.
but it implies when Xavier has this beautiful scene where he's like in bed and he's crying and he's saying like, this was the perfect night for me. They go to this house where a family take them in, like the old stick, X-Men Origins, they've done it before. Wolverine is like, oh, stay with these happy people. Shit goes down.
He didn't want to stay.
No, he didn't want to stay.
He said many times, I don't want to stay.
Yeah, for that very reason. So he's been there before. It's happened many times before in other movies. So essentially, Xavier said that he remembers now what happened. He doesn't say what it is, but implies that at Westchester, which is where the Xavier School for Gifted Students is, he may have had an episode and it killed all the students and the other X-Men. But because Wolverine has a healing factor, he didn't die. Mm-hmm. And so that's caused the die out of mutants as well. It implies that mutants have disappeared because of genetics or nobody's sure, but that might have been what the incident was.
Well, I think it would have taken a big hunk of them out.
Yeah, exactly. And so that's horrifying.
That's
that completely justifies what Wolverine. He's like, I understand you now, Wolverine. So he's dealing with that pain that all these people have died.
And at his hands.
Yeah, and it kind of relates to the old man Logan story where... And the difference between this is he's old and he's decaying. And again, it implies that the adamantium in his body is slowly poisoning him.
Yeah.
So like lead poisoning, like you said before.
Yeah.
And he hangs onto this bullet... which is an adamantium bullet that he got from X-Men Origins Wolverine when Stryker shot him in the head and he got his amnesia, which again, if he shot him in the head, doesn't make sense because it's point blank. Anyway, that he's going to kill himself.
Yeah, well, that's what's keeping him for
it. Yeah, and in the Old Man Logan comic, he's given up. He's like, I don't fight anymore. I'm just a farmer. I live with my family now. He starts a family. And again, in the movie when... Patrick Stewart says this is what a normal life is like take it in, enjoy it, like at least for this moment. You might not have it yourself, and that was a beautiful moment. But Wolverine was under the influence of Mysterio and he killed everybody. He killed all the X-Men. So he was at the X-Men mansion and he thought people were attacking and he went and killed everyone and then he realizes he's just killed all the X-Men. So he refused to fight. He lives in his own. And then circumstances draw him back in to the point where he's just like, fine, you want the Wolverine?
You want it back?
It's go time. And there were cool moments in this movie where that happened. And there was one person in the audience that clapped.
Yeah, oh my God. If that woman
something happened.
Like, anything happened. She's like, I understand she's excited. Like,
I heard her clap once.
I heard her clap like 40
times. You know what I did hear throughout
times.
The whole fucking
Me
movie?
Me chewing?
Yes. Man.
Anyway.
I've seen like 10 movies with you and like, Patrick Stewart was like dying in bed and crying, and I'm like, oh, and then.
So anyway, there was two moments for me when this happened, and one was when X-23 or Laura was at the desert, and he first finds her, and she's killing all the people, and he's like, what the hell is this? And they've got her pinned with a harpoon through the heart, and she's just about to get shot, and then the claws come through the guy, and the music swells, and Wolverine goes berserk. Yeah. And then at the end, which is the one that they're building the audience to, is when he takes drugs. So it's promoting Wolverine doing drugs.
There's a drug they used to give the child mutants that make them stronger but crazy. So they take them in small doses to kind of increase.
But it looks like venom.
And he just took a whole fucking bottle
and goes nuts and does his Wolverine.
He does the jumpy claw thing, like pushes someone into the tree.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
So that was pretty good.
That was cool. Like, and when the because the government has found the kids and the kids are running away and there's like dun 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 dun. And then you see, like just
you
off
can
in
hear
the
scream.
Yeah.
And when he was asleep, he's like, arr, arr, arr. That was pretty good. I like the beast part of Wolverine.
Yeah.
But I think
the old animal.
It's pretty dark in that it's a sad way that everything ends.
I love it, but like that's what made me. That's what made me sad, but that's also made me really happy because what this movie is. The biggest problem with superhero franchises is they never end. Like Marvel Studios will make Marvel movies until we're all fucking dead.
Mm-hmm.
So, but for him, like he went out. There was no after credit sequence. Nothing.
Same as the Dark Knight Rises. Yeah, Christian Bale.
See, that was open ended ending. I disagree with that.
It's that close enough.
Yeah, but they still put the illusion of, there's a Nightwing, and, you know. But, like, this is, like, finale. Like, he's dead, period. You know, Xavier's dead, so it essentially ends...
All the old X-Men are dead.
Yeah, it ends that X-Men storyline, which is massive and powerful, and I think that's where it hit me the most, the idea of... Because he said 17 years we've been watching X-Men films. Like, I'm 28. You know, that's...
I'd love to see... in a few years' time, you know, this trailer happened. And what is this? And it's like, Laura. Yeah. That's her own solo.
X-23.
Well, that's the thing again. My argument...
The big difference with Laura is that she's traded away her middle claw for foot claws.
Yeah, foot claws.
And she kicked a dude in the balls with her foot claw. That was horrifying.
But in terms of, like, I think that, like, with the... I'll just wrap up my last thing with the... Sure. Having that final moment is... It was just... I can't even explain.
I was holding it in because I'm in public.
Oh, dude, I've been wanting to cry for fucking days, and like I needed a reason, and this sort of did the job.
So there was two things towards the end. Is
I'm like, man, I hope Wolverine dies. I'll cry because he didn't.
So Wolverine dies at the end. In case you haven't picked up yet, he's dead, and Laura's like all crying, and she's. He's like,
she had snot coming out. Yeah. I'm like, performance.
And then she grabs her hand. She's like, daddy.
I was like,
and then towards the end, she's dug a grave for him with a cross. And as she's walking off, she comes back and tips the cross over so it forms an X on the ground. And I was like,
which is cool, but also lame. It's in this weird middle ground.
Cool, it was good.
Like, as I went, I get it. No, that's cool. Because, like, in this world, the X-Men are this underground thing. Like, the comics exist in this world. Like, someone has made the stories of the X-Men. So, I guess that makes more sense to that, because they know him as an X-Men.
The kid had the Wolverine toy.
Yeah, the kid had a Wolverine toy.
That was awesome.
A little chubby, fat kid.
Little chubby kid.
Yeah.
That was good. But...
Let's talk, because there was... probably 10 other kid mutants, the same as Laura, that she finds, which they all have their own kind of powers. Some are cool, some are not. The one I liked, I don't know what this chick did, but these government agents are chasing her, and then she gets all the twigs, like strips bark from trees, and just
like
creates...
Like pine needles.
Yeah, like pine needles around these guys, like all in their face, and then makes a tornado around him, and then he just...
See, that moment, when I was like, that's unnecessary violence.
No, I thought that was cool.
If they literally just, like, needled the crap out of him and he fell over, I'm like, that's efficient.
Yeah, they did that in X-Men The Last Stand. They had, like, Porcupine Guy, who was just...
Yeah, but I don't remember that, because I don't remember that movie. So
again, it's more of, like, instead of coming up with cool ideas, I mean, I'm sure those characters are somebody's, and they're like, you know how you like that really cool guy, like the...
Iceman.
The Ice Cutter? Well, she blew the ice. That's Ice Cutter. And it's like, no, it's not. It's such as I'm Curl. He's got no name, no character, no personality, but she just blows ice.
All right, well, that's before we can jump into our final thoughts, because you're the Marvel guy out of all of us, where does this fit into the comic lore? Like, what have they brought multiple stories in? What have they done?
Well, like I said, they got the Reavers part of it. X-23 was originally in the X-Men Evolution cartoon series, and then she got brought into the cartoons. And
as Logan's daughter?
Well, she was a clone. The same thing. Yeah. So that Rice guy, Richard E. Grant, his father was killed by Wolverine. And he's like, I think I killed your father. And he's like, well, yeah, you did. he's like, I think I maybe did. He's like, you did. So he did the same thing in that he started developing these clone versions of people, and he used Wolverine's DNA to make X-23. And he had other versions of that leading up to her. So that part is taken out of her story. The rest is pretty much crafted. The fact that it's in 2029, X-Men Days of Future Past happened in 2025. But then again, that was an alternate future that didn't happen.
because of what took place in Days of Future Past, it eliminated that future.
Because in the
70s... What have they
70s,
done with these timelines?
Michael Fassbender and James McAvoy and guys stopped Bolivar Trask, which was Peter Dinklage, who was played by a different actor who was a black African-American man in The Last Stand. I'm not going to go into that. Mac from Predator. Bill Duke. Anyway, so, yeah, it's messy. But a few points. Go ahead.
No, go.
So, overall...
Yeah, we'll go final thoughts, I'm thinking.
Well, just before we get into final thoughts...
Yeah, go for it.
Sorry.
Fucking hell, dude. How Wolverine finds all this out is... Laura was being looked after by a Mexican lady who stole her from the hospital. And he finds out because He finds her phone. I don't know, you guys are laughing at. But he plays a video that she's made, like, explaining, like, if I'm dead, this is what's happened, and here's footage of it. And when the footage of, like, the kids being, like, the kids in the cells, I'm like, this is actually getting really dark, and I'm kind of uncomfortable right now.
Oh, really? I was laughing because the phone died, and he plugged it in to recharge it, and it happened to go exactly where the video
See,
was.
See, Dylan said that, but Sony phones do that.
Oh, really? And go Sony phones. I was like...
My problem was that she's like worked on it in Movie Maker to be like, I'm going to have my intro at the start.
Yeah,
then I'm
going
to intercut
really
footage
well.
And relate what I'm saying to the moments in the videos, and then I'm going to have my outro at the end.
That'd take 10 minutes on an app on your
Why
phone.
Is she wasting time doing that?
What do you mean? She was trying to find Wolverine.
She's trying to tell a story.
She's sitting there. She's like, please come get us. He's like, I'm not.
She's like, hey, I'm in the hotel room.
Yeah,
I got
like,
nothing
the,
to
I'm
do.
I'm in the hotel. Racist. Please come and get us. And
I'm doing the character.
And he's like, I'm not coming yet. She's like, oh, I'll just make this video then.
So I go, she's asleep.
Take the content of the video with what you will, but it was actually, like, to think about that, that's actually really fucking dark. Right. What's happening there?
Yeah. I 100% agree. Final thoughts, Dylan? And a rating out of 5. If we feel
the problem, again, it's not so much the Wolverine, because the trilogy started out horrible, pretty good, and good, strong finish. For the Wolverine trilogy. My problem is the X-Men movies 1 and 2 and to some point 3 are all Wolverine stories anyway. So, and it's the same thing again. I go on about, like, X-Men has the potential to be like a science fiction fantasy with like the Shi'ar Empire. It has the opportunity to be like a pop culture satire with the Mojoverse. It can be like an adventure movie with the Savage Land and Sauron and all that.
Sauron from Lord of the Rings.
Sauron, the big red eye. He's a pterodactyl. No, he's not a big red eye. He's a man that turns into a pterodactyl.
Holy shit.
That's the movie I watched.
Yeah, exactly. It's got all these other places it can go, and yet they do the same government following Wolverine. And my argument is, you could have the same thing. Wolverine's dying. He dies at the end because he's sick. And there are parallels between X-23 and him, like, don't let the rage get you, you've only killed bad people. It alluded to it, but it didn't quite get the emotional strength to it. It was more the other movies that kind of built you, because you know Wolverine and it gets to that. I feel they could have put anything in the middle, and as long as he's sick and he's shitty and old and he dies at the end, it would have been the same movie.
But being the final... But
it's
being
the emotional core that makes it good.
But being the final movie of the trilogy... You can't exactly introduce a whole new fucking world and story either. Mm. Like, this is the end.
But even then, all of that is made up. Like, none of that was in any of the other movies.
Yeah, I know, but I think... Are you done?
I was just going to say, I did like the way, and not even necessarily in a good way, but it's clever, that they made the clone Wolverine look a little like Sabretooth.
Yeah.
Like, had the bald head, the mutton chops, the vest. I think that was intentional. But yeah, they did allude to X-Men Origins and kind of like, it's not so bad. It kind of goes into it to try and redeem it a little bit. But like I said, it was a good movie. It was entertaining. It's the same thing, different day. The violence was in it, which was sometimes cool when he lops people's... Well, that wasn't him, but the other Wolverine lopped people's heads off at the start when he kills all the dudes with the things. But it could have been anything else and he would have had the same emotional punch, I feel. Like, nothing in the middle was done artfully well. There was a couple of good jokes where he's like, hey, this is my dad. I like the dynamic between the three of them with the dad. But Professor X at the start was like some high, crazy person. Only to the very end did he start become the professor you know him as. So it was really the banter between them being father and son. That was the only slight jokes that worked in the dynamic between them. But everything else was just kind of like, eh.
Out of five?
Jeez. Remember, 3 is 2.5 is like
two good. And a half is a 5 out of 10.
So I go 3.5.
3.5. Okay. Sure. I think, like, because you're the big Marvel movie fan and comic fan, so you know all the history and all that. Coming from a casual observer,
yeah.
Like what you're saying with same story, different setting, different day. I think that's actually, for me anyway, that's kind of. That is Wolverine's story, is that he spent all these movies, all these years, all this time just trying to get the fuck away from what happened, and it just keeps coming back to him. And that's actually a really sad thing. Like, and they did play it up in this when he said, I didn't ask for this, and it was... I got the notion that everything we've seen of Wolverine in the movies, that's what he's referring to. Everything. I didn't ask for any of this. And I think that's what actually puts, like, the pinpoint on this movie. Yeah, it's the same thing, different day, but that... As far as Marvel movies go, that is Wolverine. That is his story. That's his story alone, that he's been trying for so long to just get away from all this, and it just keeps following him again and again and again. And to see him kind of get the last little bit of revenge, I guess, whether it's the end of that particular story not involving Wolverine, you know, because they did have the base with the other mutants, and it looked like there was heaps of them. Whether they're going to do something else with that, I don't know.
They are talking about doing like the new mutants story.
Yeah. And if Laura's in it, like, I'm all in, because she was awesome.
Again, yeah.
So yeah, I think it wasn't a fantastic movie, but it was a great movie.
Yeah.
It was better than good.
Yeah.
Performances were genuine. The CGI in terms of like being cut open and lopping limbs was schmick. I don't feel like the violence was too much. I thought it was just right. Like what you'd expect from Wolverine just going ham on people.
Yeah, that's true.
And Laura is a very agile little girl.
Mm.
I'm sure she had a stunt double or something. But like we've seen Wolverine fight 100 times by now, but they still find ways just to introduce cool new little things that you're like, oh, I haven't seen him do that before. That's kind of cool. And when they gave Laura the foot blades, I was like,
cartwheels and stuff.
Yeah, and then for whatever reason, Professor Xavier compares her to a female lion because they have claws on their feet for
like Wolverine's
protection.
Yeah,
or something like that.
I don't know if the doctors knew that at the time.
I had a 4 out of 5. I don't have too much more to say about it. I just thought it was just an entertaining movie, and I thought it brought, even though, like Dylan said again, it's the same thing, different movie. To me, that is Wolverine's story.
Okay,
so that works for that. Me.
To me, I think the movie was simply fantastic. Not perfect, but I thought it was exceptional. Performances were really good. Hugh Jackman brought it so hard. There were some very weird things with Patrick Stewart, as I mentioned at the start, with him sort of being this high, weird dude. But to have that relationship build, and, you know, you do see the collection of 17 years worth of X-Men movies come together into one moment. As much as I dislike, I wasn't a really big fan of him fighting clone him. Mm. I do see the symbology behind it of well, as in this is old him. Your past is coming to kill you, you know, and it's the whole idea that he will be the death of himself, and his actions and that sort of stuff.
Oh,
so
symbolic. Wow.
Yeah, so I think I'm looking to a little bit more rather than just seeing him as the clone villain. Like you look into it a little bit more that way. Because, you know, he talked about how, like, he was going to kill himself, and he somewhat did, you know, I went into this movie, I didn't expect to feel, I thought I would just get a movie that I would enjoy,
which you did.
I did, but I didn't expect to have such an emotional response to that movie. I do agree with Dylan in terms of some of the middle part could have been altered or moved and it wouldn't have taken away, but unlike Apocalypse as an example, like there are moments where there were dips and I genuinely was like, fuck this. I looked at my phone. Like this movie had me the whole way through. It's everything that I want in a superhero movie. This movie is what I want DC films to be. I want it to be dark and be unapologetic about it and know exactly what it is and like have faith to your source material.
Dark with a cause.
Dark with a cause and like an emotional depth to it. So not just being dark for the sake of being dark. You know, but like with, you know, the Marvel is light and happy. Like, people were laughing at parts of this movie that I thought were completely unnecessary. Like, as in people were laughing at things that aren't meant to be funny. Like, him running through the forest. I'm like, no, he's fucking intent. Like, I guess I watch it on a different level to everybody else in that room, but maybe. Hence why that lady was clapping and wanted to punch her in the face.
Yeah, there's casual viewers.
I'm like, she cried as well. I saw her wipe away tears. I'm like, you were just really into this movie, lady. At the end, I'm like, fuck this lady. And then I saw her, I'm like, no, we get it. We're cool.
What I do want to add is just... another thing that is with like X-23 or Laura, they cast actors, like the kids are like actors. Mm. It's like they've done a casting and you're like, kids, just act tough, you know? They look like clean kids there. Like they're not like these lost boys that are living up in this thing. And again, with X-23, I don't think she's an actor that might be able to carry, like Wolverine is carrying the franchise, Hugh Jackman.
100%.
And so I don't think she's got the acting chops to do that. Like, as a good child actor, but not as a good actor. Yeah. Like, not a Haley Joel Osment standout kind of performance. Yeah. And so they'll recast her. And it's always annoying when they hire, like, actors who look like models and suit the physical character, but then they can't act. Like, Daniel Cudmore as Colossus, and then they kept him, and you're like, like, Colossus in Deadpool, incredible.
Yeah, that's awesome.
But the thing that makes me sad is that this is the final story in the chronological order of the X-Men.
The original X-Men.
Yeah, the X-Men movie. Even the First Class, kind of. Well, it's in the First Class universe. That's a sad ending to know that all the struggles and civil rights and the X-Men stories end up in, like, everybody dies.
I love it for that reason. Exactly.
And it's just a sad, horrible ending.
It's not a horrible ending. No. It's a sad ending.
But everybody's dead. Like, all their struggles, all their cares, all their heroics.
Because of...
For nothing.
Themselves.
And that sometimes happens. You know what I mean? Like, not everything needs to be that lovely, happy ending. You know, and they all lived happily ever after.
For Wolverine, I can understand. But for everyone, that's just depressing.
They're already dead.
Mm. But, as I said, to wrap it up, I think this movie is just on point. As I said, not perfect, but it's a good, solid, like, 4.5 out of 5 for me. When I went through our list of the best movies we thought would come out of this year, I did think this was one of it, and it probably will be, I think will easily be my probably top 2 favorite movies of the entire year.
Wow.
Top 2. Ooh, what's the other contender?
Don't know yet. I'll always leave it open. It's number one right now.
It's already number two.
All I know is that, like, there'll be something that might come out later that hasn't done it yet. But, like,
next week?
I've seen, like, 3 Justice movies League. This year. One of them was Assassin's Creed. So.
Is it above Assassin's Creed?
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah. So this is the superhero movie that I want. It's fucking excellent. I'm Ryan Benson.
I'm Josh Saunders.
I'm James Howlett, Logan Wolverine.
Please go see Logan. It's really good.
Tweet at Hugh Jackman and say, "Dear picture."
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah.